Now, this week, a new ride-sharing app was supposed to launch in the US, but its publicist tells us that it's being put off because of how huge the response is, which is the sort of thing a publicist would say. It is called Chariot. Basically, think Uber, but for women, women drivers and women passengers only.
That's right. It is exactly like that baby shower you definitely didn't want to go to. It's no boys allowed, except for the dad, who in this very complicated metaphor is the person who created the service, who's a guy. Yeah, just watch this.
This is Michael Pellets. He was an Uber driver in Boston. One night, he picks up a drunk dude who's kind of violent. As guy, he reckons he felt uncomfortable and thought, imagine how women drivers must feel. So he came up with this.
Chariot for Women, a soon-to-be-launched car service exclusively for women passengers.
That's right, women passengers, women drivers, women everything.
Hell, it's about time.
Is one way to look at it. Ride-sharing services, including Uber, have come under some scrutiny of late.
I literally have 1,000 questions.
Like, are sexual assault cases being handled correctly? Are background checks stringent enough? Should the contact details of female drivers be readily available?
I don't know. That's a good question.
Now, you might be asking, well, what about taxis? And the answer is...
Oh, my God, who the hell cares?
Now, back to ride-sharing. Chariot says it wants to make it safer, but again...
I literally have 1,000 questions.
Or just a couple, really. One, is it even legal? And two, will it really take off?
All I know is my gut says maybe.
The argument against its legality is that it discriminates against men. What? That's a legitimate concern. Some people think it's not fair, guys. Stop looking at me like that. The other question is, how successful will it become? Because services like this have actually existed for years in places like Europe and the Middle East, but they remain relatively on the fringes. Now, there's one more questionable element here, that a service by women for women is actually run by a man, who a few days ago explained his other reason for setting it up.
When I was 11 years old, Pretty Woman came out. From that point on, I just always saw myself like Richard Gere. I just love and cherish and respect women so much that to me it's just natural.
Right.
That's not to say men can't establish businesses for women, but it does raise the question of whether such services can be patronising. Shut up, that's a real thing!
Still, there's an anecdotal scale of safety when it comes to being driven around as a woman. Ask any woman, I bet their response is going to be Chariot, female Uber drivers, male Uber drivers, taxi drivers in peak hour, and taxi drivers in peak hour listening to 2GB.
So, you know, maybe it'll be a good thing if it comes to Australia, if only because you never have to listen to 2GB again.
And joining us now, levitating above a cityscape somewhere, is Uber driver slash lady Karen Day. Karen, ladies only car share, a good or bad thing?
Well, I think it's a great thing. I know women definitely want it, but yeah, I think it's going to be great. I think it's great for women in Sydney.
Have you ever had a hairy incident, or do you know somebody that has, that you think an app like this might have made a difference?
Well, to be honest, I've not had a single bad ride the whole time I've been driving for Uber, which is over 12 months. So I've not heard of anything that's happened that's precarious. But I know that lots of women that I've picked up definitely want this kind of service. They feel like, they just feel vulnerable, I suppose, not knowing who's picking them up, even though there is this app around it and there's a lot of safety measures in place. I know that people do feel as though they, yeah, would just prefer a woman driver.
Can I say, when you pick up women compared to when you pick up men, is there a difference for you there as a driver?
Yeah, I suppose there's more, there's definitely that sort of, maybe more of an empathy with the women and also with younger girls. So making sure that you drive them right to the house and make sure they get into their front door instead of just kind of leaving them at the side of the street.
Because I guess the argument against a ride-sharing app like Chariot, for example, is that ride-sharing apps in general are generally quite safe. Yes, there are incidents, but they're very few and far between. So is something like this even necessary?
Well, maybe it's not, but I think it's more about this perception that women have. I know that women do feel like more vulnerable than men do. And I know, like, I've picked up so many women that do say they would love a woman service, woman-only service, and knowing they can call a woman to have a woman pick them up.
So if Chariot were to launch here today and you were given a choice, work for Uber, work for Chariot, who would you pick? I know, tough question. That's right. We're a new program. Tough question.
It's fine.
You can't say anything bad about your employer.
Yeah, I'd definitely love to work for an all-woman service. I think it would be great. I think this kind of like disruptive technology really is empowering women to make money in different ways. Mm. It's also, you know, it's got women like myself can actually go out and make money whenever you want. And so I feel like if there is this woman-only service, women will be more empowered to actually be drivers as well.
All right. Thank you, Karen, for chatting with us today.
No worries.